meeting today on this first sitting of 18th Lok Sabha, which is a solemn occasion. A new Lok Sabha vested with great and onerous responsibilities for ensuring the welfare of the entire country and our people has been elected under the Constitution. Considering the solemnity of this occasion, and as is customary, we may all stand in silence for a short while before we begin our proceedings. Om Shanti. I congratulate all the members who have been elected to the 18th Lok Sabha. It gives me great pleasure to welcome all the members. I'm sure you will all help the chair in maintaining the high tradition of this house and thereby strengthening the edifice and the roots of our democratic polity. I wish you all success in your endeavor. Now I would request the Secretary General to lay on the table a list, Hindi and English versions, containing the names of the members elected to the 18th Lok Sabha at the general election of 2024, submitted by the Election Commission of India.
Sir, I lay on the table a list, Hindi and English versions, containing the names of members elected to the 18th Lok Sabha at the general elections of 2024, submitted by the Election Commission of India.
I have to inform the House that the Honorable President has nominated the following members as members of the panel of chairpersons: Sri Suresh Kodikonal, Sri Talikottai Raju Thevar Balu, Sri Radha Mohan Singh, Sri Fagan Singh Kulaste, Sri Sudeep Bandopadhyay. Honorable members, I have to inform the House that Honorable Speaker had received Please have your seat. Now here is an important announcement to make. Honorable members, I have to inform the House that Honorable Speaker had received a letter dated 17th June 2024 from Sri Rahul Gandhi, an elected member from the Wayanad parliamentary constituency of Kerala, resigning his seat in Lok Sabha. The Honorable Speaker has accepted the resignation of Sri Rahul Gandhi with effect from 18th June. The names of members will now be called by the Secretary General for the purpose of making and subscribing an oath or affirmation. The Leader of the House, Honorable Prime Minister, will be called first. Thereafter, members of the panel of chairperson will be called. Then ministers of cabinet rank, ministers of state independent charge, and ministers of state. Thereafter, the names of other members, state, union, territory-wise, in alphabetical order, will be called. The names of members who are not able to take the oath or make the affirmation at the first call will be called again at the end. If the name of any member is not pronounced correctly, it may be kindly be excused. Honorable members, on the name of a member being called by the Secretary General, the member may proceed from the place she or he is occupying to one of the podiums placed on either side of the Speaker's chair. A copy of the form for oath or affirmation in accordance with the third schedule to the Constitution of India, as the case may be, will be kept for the use of the member. The member will face the House while making the oath or affirmation and then wish the chair. Thereafter, the member will proceed to show the original election certificate at the table of the House and sign the roll of members, which is placed on the table. Now, Secretary General.
Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi.
दामोदर दास मोदी, जो लोकसभा का सदस्य निर्वाचित हुआ हूं, ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूं कि मैं विधि द्वारा स्थापित भारत के संविधान के प्रति सच्ची श्रद्धा और निष्ठा रखूंगा। मैं भारत की प्रभुता और अखंडता अक्षुण्ण रखूंगा तथा जिस पद को मैं ग्रहण करने वाला हूं उसके कर्तव्यों का श्रद्धापूर्वक निर्वहन करूंगा।
श्री कोडिकुनिल सुरेश, श्री टी आर बालू, श्री राधा मोहन सिंह,